A very good evening, Dutch bike blogger here. Thank you for riding with me. And as you can see, it's already quite dark. It's 20:42. So 18 minutes before 9 in the evening. It's Sunday, the 4th of August 2022. Still nice weather, still wearing shorts, slip-flops and a sleeveless shirt. Just left the area of Waterland, sorry, Zonland. I'm getting back home on my bike. It's been a very nice day. Visited my brother, had a barbecue. Parents were there too, so we had a nice talk, and as we had with my brother, we went and brought my parents back home. I don't know what it is with me and cars, but every time I go by car, I get car sick. When we went and brought my parents back home, I was sitting in the back of the car, car sick. A little bit busy with pedestrians, and when I went back from where my parents back to Groningen, I sat in the front passenger seat, also car sick, so wondering if I can do something about it, because it's annoying, feeling that you get nauseous and nauseated and feeling that you have to throw up and dizzy. Probably has to do with the equilibrium. It's a small organ in your brain is responsible for that, and probably it's not working as it should be. Quite annoying. I have to say, I only get that problem when I the car of my brother's, when his wife is driving, less issues or no issue at all. And when I'm in the car with my father, no problem at all. So probably has to do with some driving style or type of car, I don't know. But I have to figure out how to avoid this in future, because it's quite annoying. Not very pleasant to ride a car this way. This time, by the way, I asked Self to go in the car to bring my parents home with my brother, but next time I probably will skip. Let's take a turn here. Exactly the same, or somewhat the same route as I took when I went here, except for the first part of this video. By the way, there was a card in the beginning of the video to the video before this one, and also I will provide you with the link in the description box like I always do. when there is no not any other circumstances to put a card in on a different time, and I tell you a time, normally when the video starts about 7 seconds in, there will be the card to the top right corner to the video before the video you're watching now. That's standard. Sometimes, more often than not, I will refer to an older video, and then I will put a card later in or other specific time. That's how things I do. Has to do with the continuity, so you're able to follow the videos like you. It's an easy way. And since I do my videos in parts, or most of them, I try to provide you with links and cards and whatnot. Normally, when this video comes online, I will go one video back and put an end screen in. That's the clickable small screens you have at the end of the video, the end screens put in by the YouTuber themselves. You can click on them . Don't know if my backlight is still running. Let's have a look. Backlight somehow went off. I switched it on again. Not sure what happened. Probably is empty or just bumped into the off switch. Not sure about that. But I switched it on again. But looks it rather quickly switched off, so it's probably empty. That's not good. Huh, annoying. Let's try and fix that with another bike light I have with me. I'll get going again with a spare bike light. The first video I actually told about that I had two bike lights with me for the front and the back, and talking about redundancy. Did not think I needed it, but I do. I have a battery powered bike light. I suspect the normal bike light I use is a rechargeable one with USB. It's just empty. I switch it on, then it burns for 10 seconds and then it goes off. So probably it's not fully charged anymore. I have to figure out if the charge does do the trick. My front light I did charge a while ago, but it's not a bad idea to charge the backlight too once in a while. So I suspect that's the problem. And that's always a good idea to have or spare batteries with you, or your battery operated bike lights, or like I said, redundancy. De Ulgersmaweg en heading towards what used to be the Gerrit Krolbrug. Let's get over there, walk on it. Walk over the bike bridge, except for the bridge is still accessible. Tilt the camera a bit, so you actually can see stuff, although it's dark. Well, a bit of a bummer that the bike light did not do the job. Like I said, I suspect user error not charging it. I did not use it for a while, and then I used it a longer time for at the 28th of August, and I never recharged it, so I thought it was okay, but probably not. Well, we're gonna see. Gonna inform you in the next video how that went. Well, made it down the stairs, gee. And it's up at the Korreweg. Let's end the video here. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel if you're not a subscriber yet and you do think it's watchable. If you have a comment, please put it in the description or the comment section below. I will see you next time. Have a great day, and like always, be safe out there.